big 1990s Philips used to make vacuum cleaners. We've seen them dotted around, bless them. This is one of the more rarer ones. I have certainly never seen one. This is a Philips Turbo Silence, or Blue Magic Silence, or TC739. Yes, 739. And this is Mr. James's. And he's asked if it can come here to perhaps be given a little TLC, you know, perhaps do something about some of the excellent modifications that it has. And there's some other bits as well, which we need to look at. Let's have a look at this very rare, very premium vacuum cleaner and see what is going on. Yes, hello my vacuum cleaner chums, how are you today? Yes, this machine suffers from what many machines of the 1990s do, and that is these stupid popper, you know, click it down and it clicks and then you push it down again. I've had this problem with Electrolux Dolphins as well, and we are actually looking at potential bodges for it rather than anything else because they're awful. But we're going to have to gloss over that. As you can see, we did... I have put some tape there, but let's have a look at the one crevice tool, which is actually from the dearly departed Philips Triathlon. Yes, why we kept that for Mr. James. If he'd been 10 minutes earlier, he could have had the upholstery tool as well, but that's sadly departed. Right, that'll last about 33 seconds. Look, you can see it going already. So we will have a look at the back of the machine whilst we can. Yes, this is the control panel side. Look, 300, 600 economy, 1,100, 1,400. We have a stall control, or a power control, and a bag full indicator, and lots of paint. Which is going to make cleaning this up an absolute pain, if these decals are not a little bit strong. Let's pull out the flex and check it. Oh, hello. Find ourselves with a modern plug. Nothing wrong with it. It's perfectly decent and matches the machine quite nicely. Whoa, that's very, very strong. Ooh, very nice. Yes, tidy controls. Back here, we have nothing, which is fine. We can sort that out absolutely easily. Put you back in there, and yeah, we will have a look under the back door, because this elastic band isn't actually doing anything to the back door. It is holding in this bag here to this part here. Crikey, I'm gonna leave it on until we've turned it on and, you know, we can use it, and then we'll take it all off and see what it's like. And in here it's obviously not working terribly well, because there is dust on the motor filter. Very good indeed. Yeah, that clip's on fire. That's literally just holding that bag on. So yes, and this is the hose end. It's like a sort of weird twisty thing. That's because the hose on this model is a push fit, like so, and that goes on there, and that bit is completely molded to that, which makes this, which I did try to hide but couldn't, more of a pain than it should be. Yeah, sadly the hose, it was like that when we got it, and I just cut the flipping thing in half because no point in caring about it anyway. Yeah, and then we can come onto the tools, look, which are here, and for such a premium, you know, decently priced, this would have been quite high-end vacuum cleaner. It has this as a floor tool. I mean, there's nothing inherently wrong with this floor tool, bar it's incredibly boring. Just does meh. It's a floor tool that it doesn't excite me at all. Then we have some tape, which is always a good sign on a cleaner that uses specific ways to... Oh, my goodness. Ooh, yeah. Okay. Oh, right. The bit's not even in there, so, right. Okay. That's going to get some nice, fresh tape on it and be left completely alone. Although, having it off is going to be slightly handy for replacing that. And then there's this. Oh, which does actually... Ah. Oh, okay. Come off. Handy, we can bond this to that. We'll epoxy it on. And this is supposedly a dust sensor. Yeah. It's probably best check if there's... Oh, there is a battery in it. I don't think it's any good anymore. It's certainly got a bit swollen. I think I've got a new one of these somewhere. Ah, yes, look, January 2001. We'll pop that to the side, and before we turn this thing on, we'll replace that. I'm sure I've probably got one somewhere. Yeah, and we'll try it out. And then a telescopic, which, oh, it's quite stiff. Or these, like, the thing I might be doing it back to front. Oh, crikey, my trousers. Yeah, we'll leave that one alone. So, yes, we have ourselves a fairly complete machine, but this is the main problem, really. We'll turn it on first, and we'll check that there's nothing else hiding, and then we'll see if we can do something with this hose. My phone rang, so I can't remember how we ended this segment and what I said we'd do next. But what we are going to do next is take our cable, plug it in, and turn it on and see if it works. We'll put it on now. Ooh, that was a bit of a grumbling start, but crikey! Whoa. Whoa! That is an air mover and a half. Crikey. And again, you can't, you know. The sound of the air coming out of the hose is more than the sound of the motor coming out of the vacuum cleaner. That is brilliant. What I want to do now is hope to gosh that this is threaded in here when I remove this hose from the centre of what's left of this bit here. We have our hose out and it is threaded. So, all we should really have to do now is cut off this part nice and clean. Then, yes! Screw that into there and dub, we have just fixed what is going to be a phenomenally tricky hose to try and find. What I also noticed, look, is that the two ends are actually the same, although the handle end has the strain relief, which obviously works incredibly well. And yes, you also, this pulls off of here, so I am going to go and have a bit of a Google and see what we can find, you know, see if we can find a replacement for this. But yeah, we can now quickly clear this away and actually do some vacuuming. Fantastic. So this is now back together. Let us now, because we sort of need this, because I'm now going to tape that back onto something, and now I know that this comes off of the wand, at least it's going to be a bit better. And I went and found a Energizer Professional, the really cheap ones that on eBay, and then we can put that on there and nothing's lit up yet, although these things are usually controlled or activated by the suction of the machine. So we'll clip that back on there, then, oh crikey, I'm going to tape this back onto here and then we can test it out. Sometimes the answer in life is just electrical tape for many, many things, and it makes it weigh an absolute ton. This probably was only a little bit longer. This would have been a very nice little manoeuvrable hose end. But, hey, we have fantastic suction. Although, still still no LEDs on our thing. But never mind, we will consider that useful because now I don't have to tape the thing straight to the wand. We can have a little bit of a break in it. And then we'll put the horrible floor tool on. I don't know, this thing's got enough airflow, it might clamp it down and be quite nice. It does. Oh yeah, okay. Okay, I think this rug really likes this floor tool, and this floor tool has enough suction behind it, enough airflow to clamp itself down and not skip around, as these are sewn over for. Like we've gone on about before, folks, sometimes it is as much the vacuum as the tool itself, and even a good vacuum can make a bad tool. See, you've got a parking slot, look, that was revolutionary in its day. Crikey, that would have added 30 or 40 pounds to the asking price for this beautiful, lovely cleaner. That is amazing, even on the economy mode. This is what vacuum used to be like. You could run them on their economical setting, you know, 650 watts all day long. Or you could go up to 1400 for your Sunday clean and then back down again for the rest of the week. Obviously nobody ever did. But the option was there, and now it is not, and this machine would be on its full power now, which would still be, you know, decent enough. I would say that the 650 odd watt motor in the Miele C3 Silence is a lot more powerful than that though, so you know, again, to compensate, they have improved. Very nice indeed. Right, the last thing that we can do now that we have done that little test, and did that test twice because I forgot to film the first one, we can take this bag off and see just what is going on and what we have to play with. I see. Right, so there's that. And yeah, this is the bag seal. I have no idea what an actual bag for one of these looks like. If it's missing anything, I think it is, because there's a thing in the front here. Ow! Look, where the bag will slot in. But, you know, I mean, there's a rubber seal here, which is probably going to be hiding a little bit more length. Not a lot, though. Oh, hang on, there's a thing there. We need to try and take this apart a bit and see just how far we can modify it, but while still retaining the spinning front. Let me go get some tools. A short time later, and the actual fix is really very, very simple indeed. If we take our inside piece, I have one of these, which is one of the adapters for older style Dyson tools to fit onto other older style Dysons. I've got loads of these. I don't need them. And with just a right amount of tape, you can wedge it in there with a nice airtight seal. Now, what we actually should do next is tip all the dust out that we had in there from before. And then, we'll put the original bag in, but it's not actually that tight of a fit. So although it's huge, we are going to put a HEPA flow in because it also really tightly seals onto that Dyson thing. And then, look, we've got rid of the elastic band. We've just got this stupid thing to fix now. Okay, there's a little bit of an air leak coming from somewhere. Let's take this off and see if it's something. Okay, it is something that I have done. I have had all of this off and then back on again. So hopefully when I have it back apart to clean it, I can work out what I've done. There is an air hole coming out of the back, which goes into there, which I think I may not have orientated the inner bit quite correctly enough to perhaps grab it, you know, to block it off. So I'm not too worried. It's not actually losing too much suction. It's just quite noisy in its airiness. So we can put the old battery into the old bag and put that by the old door, ready to go out into the old bin. Put the wand back on and, yeah, clean up this new mess that we've made. Ow! And stand on more of those stupid Dyson adapters. Bless it, definitely giving it an air leak somewhere, but I'm sure that's going to be easily fixable another day. But for now, we have our hose fixed, our bag conversion a bit more converted, and barred the top, which I do have some ideas about. This is not fixable, this is the problem. You could do that all day. It does need something new, but I don't quite know what. But we'll have a think and hopefully come up with something by the after video. So until then, I thank you very much for watching. Hope you have enjoyed, and myself and the Philips Turbo Silence will see you soon. Bye bye.